Since the Roe v. Wade decision in 1973, abortion has been legal in America. While pro-life Christians have been unsuccessful in reversing the ruling, they have been able to make gains in passing sensible restrictions on the procedure. All that might be about to change. During his run for the presidency, incoming President Barack Obama promised the nation's largest abortion provider, Planned Parenthood, that passing the so-called Freedom of Choice Act, or FOCA, would be at the top of his agenda.
Well, the first thing I'd do as president is sign the Freedom of Choice Act. That's the first thing that I'd do.
So what is the Freedom of Choice Act?
There are now 550 pro-life laws throughout the states, and the Freedom of Choice Act would actually nullify every single law.
Tawana Amon is the executive director of Broward Right to Life in South Florida.
There would be abortion on demand in America, and that's really what the abortion side wants. No restrictions, everything gone, everything off the table, and now pro-lifers are left to start over from square A.
FOCA would potentially overturn hundreds of laws. Among these are 44 states' laws concerning parental involvement, 40 state laws restricting later term abortions, 46 states' conscience protection laws for doctors, and laws in 33 states requiring pre-abortion counseling. According to a study by Michael New for the Family Research Council, the laws that would be overturned by FOCA have prevented 125,000 abortions per year. For instance, quote, the findings indicate that when a state enacts a parental involvement law, the abortion rate falls by an average of approximately 13.6%, unquote.
Some states have passed laws where the abortionist now has to allow the woman to see an image of life in the womb on an ultrasound before she has an abortion. That, of course, will fall by the wayside.
Jim McGarvey, a former pastor, has devoted himself to working full-time to combat abortion in South Florida.
A woman who is abortion-minded or vulnerable, through Christian counseling, 20 to 30% decide to keep their child. But once they've seen the image of their child on an ultrasound machine, it jumps to the 80 to 90% decide to keep their children.
A young woman who's in her teens, like 12 or 13 or 14, she's not developed emotionally, and she goes through this procedure and she doesn't understand what it is. And at that point, if the Freedom of Choice Act is passed, there'll be no laws restricting it. It will nullify the informed consent laws, meaning doctors will not tell women what's going to happen to them, the risks and complications.
Tawana Amon knows of what she speaks, having herself undergone an abortion as a teenager.
When I had my abortion, I just went in. They didn't give me any information about risks and complications. They didn't discuss the development of the unborn baby.
I have heard post-abortive women who have said they lied to me. In other words, they do not tell them what is in the womb. They call it a product of conception or a tissue blob, rather than identifying the life that is in the womb as a living human being.
A few years after her abortion, Tawana married her husband, John.
We got pregnant shortly after we got married, and then at 21 and a half weeks into our pregnancy, I lost the child. It was a sudden loss. There was no warning to it. I was devastated. I started looking information up to find out what happened. How could it happen? I spent months just grieving and feeling sadness over it. I didn't understand. And it was through the book, What to Expect When You're Expecting, that says that after 20 weeks, if you have a premature delivery, it can be due to a prior abortion. So I went and got the file, and the doctor wrote that he had given me all the information, risk, complications, nature of the procedure. I didn't get any information.